He is big, he is bad, he is charismatic, and he is a four-time world champion. Please welcome Matt Hagan to the stage.
One crew member, Ryan, stand up. He basically comes over every time that he has freed it from Leah's. And I was like, man, we got to figure a way to hire this guy. You know what I mean? And then my car chief was like, well, he does my job. I was like, well, we have two crew chiefs sometimes. Why can't we have two car chiefs? And Alex didn't like that idea, you know? But, and Bill Hoskins, I told you I was the best thing that ever happened to you, didn't I? Huh? Yeah, baby. Last time I gave a speech, it was on like a back of a receipt, you know what I mean? So I got a book, so you guys got a deep seat, chapter one, you know, I'm just playing. It's only two pages. Let's see, I got some stuff here. You know, obviously, to start off with this, is what an incredible season. I'm glad it's over with, because I don't think I could take the heat no more, man. My there's not enough just for men, you know, to be up here on the stage right now, as much pressure as it is. But, you know, the biggest thing is just our guys, they grinded like crazy, man, and we were able to turn the win light on and win a championship, and it's crazy. But, you know, I want to talk about my dad real quick. You know, the sacrifices he's made to put me in this position and to do the things I've been able to do, to surround myself with the people that I've surrounded myself with. He's led by example, and he's the type of man I've always tried to be. And he's a guy that basically, Bobby, you'd appreciate this. He's a car dealer. I watched him trade for four billy goats one time on a car deal to make $5. You know what I mean? So he's a hustler. And that's really what I've always tried to do, is hustle. And I've surrounded myself with great people. He has 42 companies and, you know, 900 employees. And it just is unbelievable. He always tells me all the time, he's like, you know, it's time to put your big boy pants on, come home, work, you know, make some money, you know. And I'm just like, I really like driving this race car, you know. So it's tough to leave here. But at the end of the day, my dad has really been one of the guys I look up to and I care about. One of the few people I care about their opinions, you know. And my wife and kids, oh my gosh, you know. My kids, my son, 16, he just turned 17, and was at the win in St. Louis. And, you know, he was like, we're going to Vegas. I'm like, no, you're not. You're 17 years old. And he ended up coming to Vegas. And my poor father brought him out there. And he was like, you could just see how wore out my dad was. He was getting kicked out of lounges and everything else. And you know, it was one of those things like, you're not quite ready. He's like, Vegas is not ready for me. I'm like, Vegas is ready for everybody, you know. So, but my wife does an amazing job with my kids. And I have some of the best kids in the world. And I just, you know, I think the biggest thing that we give up is our time out here, right? Like, we truly give our time away. And my crew guys and everybody else, we steal these guys from you, from our wives and our girlfriends and stuff like that. And thank you guys for letting these guys come out here and work. But the time that I've missed from my kids is, there's no amount of trophies, there's no amount of championships, there's no amount of money I can make that you get that back. And you learn that the hard way sometimes, but you know, when you do learn that, you do make those times, these next couple months coming up, very special, and you make sure you stay at home and you try to spend that time with those youngins, because they grow up so fast, and it's just unbelievable. You know, I just thought I just had my first one. And I got four. I'm like, where did the time go? But anyway, that's being said, it's, speaking of big kids, I want to talk about Tony Stewart. Tony Stewart is the biggest kid I know, man. Like, I love this guy. He's unbelievable. I mean, yeah. Tony, brother, I am like your little brother, I think, you know what I mean? You know, it's just, I think, I know you're as full of mischief as I am. It's just like, I'm like, I'm you're just holding me back from doing. You're like, no, we can't do this. Like, but Tony is just, he's incredible. I think what a shot in the arm for this sport to have a guy that could be anywhere and has other teams and NASCAR and dirt track and, you know, owns racetracks, and he decides to be here with us. I mean, obviously his beautiful wife is here with him most of the time, you know, so he wants to be here for that. But to be here with us and NHRA and bringing other sponsors over with cross promotion with NASCAR, it's such a shot in the arm for us. And I mean, it's unbelievable the legacy Tony already has, and I'm up here trying to make a legacy, and I can't appreciate the guy enough for just allowing me to drive his race car. There's be a pile of people that could fill my shoes, and I tell him every time we win, I'm like, thank you for letting me drive your race car, man. And I truly, truly love it, man. You make it fun. You make it something that I want to crawl in there. I want to put my mouthpiece in. I want to pull down tight. And I'm just like, and you get under the car and you're like, step on their neck. And it's like, yeah, brother, let's go. You know what I mean? But that's what drives you. You know what I mean? So, and I'm also glad he's a driver, because he's been in some tough situations. I'm like, yep, that's, you feel it. You understand. Don't yell at me next time. You know, so watching this guy grow in NHRA has been amazing. You know, and then watching his wife grow in NHRA has been amazing. She's been my teammate for a long time. And, you know, watching Tony put the parts and pieces underneath her and the crew around her and the folks that really, truly love and care about her, and watch her flourish from last year to this year, to what she's done as a competitor, to show up for this countdown, to go up there to have a coin flip basically at the final round of the final race, for a competitor like Doug that's been out here for so many years to do this, and she's right there battling it out, is unbelievable. And you know, it's one of those things where I am so proud of her as a driver. I know Tony's proud of her as a driver, but also as a husband. But it's something that when you can watch someone grow and come into their element and do that, it's amazing, you know. So I'm proud to have her as a teammate. I'm proud to have Tony as a team owner, as a brother, as just a good dude that would just like I said, I'm building my legacy here with Tony and with my guys and everything else we're doing. And it's just an honor to be here and do that. You know, I think there's a running tally of how right now I think I've got more kisses on TV with Tony than Leah does. So I'm sure Leah's gonna work on that. But right now I've been kissing Tony a whole lot, you know. And speaking of kissing, you know, it's basically Chad Green. I when I crawled in your car, I know, brother, that you were so glad you had your helmet on, right? Like, he's like, I got my visor down, my head sack on, and I was just like, come here, rip your helmet. I was like, I'm kissing you, brother. You know what I mean? But it's one of those things where you hate to go up there and wait on someone to lose. And I never wish bad on anybody, and I'm never going to go up there and do that. And that's why I was like, I don't even want to watch, you know, that team over there with Robert and what they do. They're an amazing group of guys, and they do just an amazing job. But you know, that's one thing I want to talk about is the respect that I have for Robert Height. That guy is just, I feel like we're cut from he deserves a round of applause. He's a fierce competitor, and he drives straight up. Like, that guy is, I feel like we're cut from the same cloth. It's no bullshit up there. It's like, hey man, we don't have to roll it in. Let's see what you got. Let's see what our crew chief's got. Let's race these race cars. And I love that. That drives me so much to when I get to run up against Robert, I get excited about it. And I know he does the same thing, but that guy stood up there beside the championship deal, listening to me talk on TV for 5 minutes, and waited very humbly to give me a thank you and congratulations. So nothing but pure respect for you, Robert, your team, Jimmy, the whole group you guys have over there, your class acts, man. Yeah. So to talk a little bit about our season and being so glad that it's over, it's like, man, you battle all year long. And I'm exhausted. You get exhausted from showing up every round. You're just like, man, don't mess up. You don't want to be that weak link, or you don't want to feel human. You know what I mean? You feel like you just got to give all the time. And our battle this year has been probably the most fierce battle I've been in my career. I've been out here 15 years now, and I've seen a lot of people come, a lot of people go, sponsors come and sponsors go. And you know, it's just the intensity of this year. And for us to win 6 races, as tough and as tight as it is, I think there's only eight guys that have won out there. Think about that, all the millions of dollars that are spent, all the time and energy and effort, and all the teams that are out here, and there's only 8 guys taking trophies home. That's so intense. That's so incredible that you were able to, we were able to take 6 of them home. And it's just, it's unbelievable, you know? So our guys, man, the blood, the sweat, the tears. I mean, I always, anytime there's a camera in my face, I always was like, try so hard to say how proud I am of you know, Dickie Venables and Alex Conway and Mike Knutson, and those guys are our key guys. But the boys at Wrench, man, like you guys, God, I love you, man. Like it's just, it's truly, you go to work every day and it's 110 degrees sometimes and you're working over a wood stove and there's no complaining, there's no BS, there's just, let's go. I had a guy that was in a car wreck and almost lost his life, and he's over here with a broke spleen and ribs and everything else. He's like, well, when can we wrench again? You know what I mean? It's like, he wants to come to work. He wants to be there. And Tony has created that environment to where we want to come to work, man. And that's really what key. When you guys that show up and want to be there, you got guys that are going to win races for you. You know what I mean? And that's everything, you know, and we see it every day in there, and how much dedication and how much hard work they put in. It's just, it's unbelievable. And, you know, and there's good days and there's bad days. And, you know, there's obviously in drag racing, I got to feel like a manic depressant the other day. You know, it was like the lows of lows that we just lost. And then, you know, watch Robert go out and we win the championship, and watch Bob in front of us, you know, go out. And it's just like, man, you know, just tough, man. It pulls on your heartstrings, like your body of work all year long. And it comes down to just one round with 3 fierce competitors, with Bob and Robert and ourselves, and even Caps, man. I mean, Caps is, he's a badass. He corrupted me earlier on in my day. So like, thanks a lot for that, Caps. But it just, it's one of those things where our body of work spoke for itself today, or yesterday, and we were able to have enough points to be able to win the championship. And that's tough to do out here, because there's a lot of tough cars out here, but some days are worse than others, you know, and there's a really smart, talented welder, Chloe, that she gave me a quote one time, and I keep it in my phone here. And it says, champions aren't merely made. They're hand forged by God through triumph over every tribulation encountered. Pressure is what champions welcome, knowing that in the face of adversity, they can shoulder the pressure to win, and they will win. And that's something she came up with, and it's just, it sticks with me. You know, it's like, when it's tough, you read those and you dig deep, man, and you dig deep for your guys. And Dickie Venables and Mike Knutson and Alex Conway, God, I love digging deep for you guys, you know what I mean? Even though, like, that scares me to death to go up there and go like, you know, I didn't do my job. You know, I was so scared the other day. I was like, we got to race Paul Lee. You know what I mean? Paul Lee's was like cutting 30 lights. I'm like, I'm good, but I don't think I'm going to be that good tomorrow. You know what I mean? So it was just, I was all spooled up about it, man, you know, because you don't want to be that weak link, you know? So it's just one of those things where we really work hard for each other. And I think that's where we're at today. But get, not trying to ramble. You know, I felt like I did a John Force the other day up there. I was just like, dodge, 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 Mopar, and I left, and I was like, read the car, you know what I mean? Like, I didn't know, sometimes you're just lost for words, you know? But not rambling anymore. It's, I do want to thank Dodge, you know, Mark Whitney, Matt Ambrosiak. We've had a 15-year relationship, man, and it's been amazing what they put together. That, they were a big part of us coming over here to TSR, making this happen with Tony, putting this together. The behind-the-scenes stuff is unbelievable, what Tony has done and what Dodge and Mark Whitney and the whole group has put this deal together. What a relationship I've had with them for so many years, man. And all the stupid stuff I've said and all the stupid stuff I've done, and they still stick with me. It's like, man, you guys, I don't know. I'm sure you can find a better driver out here. But I feel like we're a workhorse, man. We work hard. We show up. We win races. And that's what they want. You know what I mean? They want to see that win light come on. And that's what we do for them, you know. And American Rebel, Andy Ross, brother, I don't, if this dude's got a shot in the arm, he's hooked. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is, he's come to, I think he's our good luck charm. He's come to like 3 races, and we won 2 of them and runner up 1. And I think Tony said, well, if you don't figure out how to get here, we're going to send a jet for you. You know what I mean? So it's one of those things, to have a guy like that is unbelievable, because he's just real and he's raw, and he has an opportunity to just be himself out here, and he wants us to be ourselves out here. And I have the pleasure of having sponsors like that, you know, with him and Larry and everybody. It's been really cool to have them a part of this. And talking about cool people, you got Jason Johnson, man. I want to gamble behind that guy tonight because he picked Erica's team, he picked our team, and you know that dude obviously knows how to pick winners. So you know, I can't say enough about him and his, you know, obviously Mike and his brother Chris, and you know, that's an inside joke, but we we love you guys, man, and just being able to do shots in the trailer after we win and stuff like that, and just being wholesome and real is what it's really all about. Let's see. Obviously, we had Renai, Haas Automation, Heatwave, Mobile One. Obviously, Mobile One's a big sponsor for Tony. They allow him not to take my seat from me because he's driving his hay fuel deal, and they fund that. So thank you, Mobile One, for keeping me in the seat for a little while. And you know, obviously, we have so many behind-the-scene group, you know, with Kelly Antonelli and Ashley Wilson and all the folks, you know, Mike with the cook and everything else. It takes everybody to do what we do out here. You guys all know that. You've been my peers for 15 years, and you guys know what it takes to do it, and it takes everyone to do that. And it's unbelievable I get to stand up here with you guys tonight and really celebrate four-time champion in a funny car, which is one of the fiercest, craziest things I've ever been in my life. I've drove drag boats and circle track cars and monster trucks and Scott. I mean, nothing compares to me of what we do in a funny car. And I'm just so proud to be up here and to be able to be a part of this with you guys, my peers that I respect and obviously appreciate everything we all do together. But I just wanted to say, basically, at the end of the day, you know, yeah. Fortune favors the bold. Yeah, I'm sorry. I was trying to figure out my quote there. Fortune favors the bold, and we did it, boys. So I appreciate you guys. I love y'all. Let's go party. I'm tired of talking. I can't even read no more. So you guys go have fun. Thank you guys again.